Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 5.5. In this section we will see a special differential equation which is called Euler equations. This is a second order linear homogeneous differential equation, and its general form is given as a times t squared the second derivative of the variable y plus b times t times the first derivative plus c times y is equal to 0, where a, b and c are real constants. So how can we find a formula for the solution of such equations? So we will look for power function solution for this differential equation. The solution function will be a power function which is given by t to the power r, where r is a constant. So to find a formula, namely to find r, we will benefit from the equation by taking the first and second derivative of the solution function, which is the power function. So the first derivative is equal to r times t to the power r minus 1, and the second derivative is obtained from the previous one, r times r minus 1 times t to the power r minus 2. In this section we will find the value of r to find the general solution of such equations, which called Euler equations. Okay, Euler equations. So after finding first and second derivative, we put them into the equation, so we obtain this one, a times t squared times r times r minus 1 times t to the power r minus 2 plus b times t times the first derivative written here, and c times itself is equal to 0. And from here we know t squared times t to the power r minus 2 is equal to t to the power r, and t times t to the power r minus 1 is equal to t to the power r. Therefore, the multiplication of them, these terms, will be t to the power r, and the multiplication of them will be t to the power r, and in the third term we have the same quantity. So by taking a parenthesis in terms of t to the power r, so we obtain t to the power r times a times r to the power r minus 1 plus b times r plus c is equal to 0. So from here we obtain a polynomial equation with respect to r, and this is called the characteristic equation for the Euler equation written here. So you should be careful, the characteristic equation has the form a times r minus 1 plus b times r plus c. Okay, and solving this polynomial equation, namely finding the root of this equation, so we obtain a power function solution for the differential equation. According to the roots, we should have two special solutions such that the linear combination of them will form a general solution for the differential equation, for the Euler equation. So the first possibility, you know, this is a second degree polynomial equation, so we can have distinct real root, namely different real roots. For example, let's solve the differential equation t squared times the second derivative minus 4 times t times the first derivative plus 4 times y is equal to 0. When we check the general form, so instead of a we have 1, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 4, I guess, b is the coefficient of t, and the coefficient of t is minus 4 here, and c is equal to 4. Therefore, the characteristic equation from here will be a times r times r minus 1, namely r times r minus 1 plus b times r, namely minus 4r plus 4. And from here we obtain r square minus 5r plus 4 is equal to 0. And the factors of this polynomial equation will be r minus 1 and r minus 4, which means r is 1 or r is equal to 4. Then the power y1 is equal to t to the power r, namely t, and y2 is equal to t to the power 4, and the linear combination of them will be y is equal to c1t plus c2 t to the power 4. This is the general solution of the differential equation of Euler equation, and you can check this is the solutions written here form a fundamental set of solutions, special solutions here, by finding the Wronskian of them, and this is not equal to zero if t is not equal to zero. Therefore, the general solution will be the linear combination of these special solutions. When we have two different real roots, just we find the value of r, and then we write the power functions, and take by writing the linear combination of them, we obtain the general solution of the Euler equation. So when we have repeated real roots, so for this we have a differential equation to understand for this case. T squared times the second derivative minus 3 times t times the first derivative plus 4 times y is equal to 0, and it is defined for positive values, and we know the power function solution, and the corresponding characteristic equation here, a is equal to 1, therefore 1 times r minus 1, and b is equal to minus 3, minus 3 times r plus 4 is equal to 0. And from here we have r squared minus 4r plus 4, and this is actually written as r minus 2 to the power 2, which means we have the only root, which is the number 2, and it is repeated 2 times. Therefore, one of the special solutions for the Euler equation given in the example is t squared, t to the power r corresponds to t squared. Okay? Therefore, y1 is equal to t squared. It solves the differential equation. To find the second solution, which and they are linearly independent, so we use the method of reduction of order, if you remember. So the second solution y2 of t will be equal to u of t times the first solution, which is t square. Okay, and to find the definition of the function u of t, we will benefit from the equation. For this, we find the general solution y2. We find the first and second derivative to use the differential equation to find u of t. And the first derivative is equal to, using the product rule from here, t squared times u prime plus 2t times u. And the second derivative is similarly obtained by using the product rule for the terms written here in the addition. The first one times the second derivative of the second one, namely the derivative of the second term, plus 2t, namely the derivative of the first one, 2 times t, times the second one. Similarly, you will obtain the derivative of the second term by using the product rule written here. And by arranging them, we obtain t squared times the second derivative of the function u plus 4t u prime plus 2u. And for the second derivative, we write this term. For the first derivative, we write this one. And we write itself written here. Therefore, from the definition of the differential equation written here, so you obtain t squared times the second derivative, namely this one, written here, minus 3t times the first derivative, this one, written here, plus 4 times itself, namely u of t times t squared, written here. And by arranging this statement, so we obtain t to the 4 times the second derivative of u plus the terms written here, and after simple calculation, simple algebra, we obtain t to the power 4 times the second derivative plus t to the power 3 times the first derivative, and from here we obtain actually t cube times this term, and we look for the definition of u for every value of t. Therefore we take the parentheses, namely this one from here, so we have t times the second derivative minus the first derivative. Okay, and from here, instead of the first derivative, to make easier the calculation of this equation, so we write v for the first derivative of u. Therefore, the equation becomes t times v prime minus v. And from here, we see that this is actually a separable differential equation, or directly we can understand that the left hand side of this differential equation is actually the expansion of the derivative of the multiplication of t and v, because according to the product rule, we have the derivative of v times the other function here minus the derivative of this one, which is 1, and the other function v, which means this is actually the derivative of the product of t and v, okay, the left hand side, and the right hand side is equal to 0. By taking the integral of both sides of the equation, so we obtain t times v is equal to c1, which is the integral constant, and v is equal to c1 over t, and we know v is equal to u prime. And again, taking the integral of both sides of this equation, so we obtain u is equal to c1 times the integral of 1 over t, which is equal to ln theta plus the integral constant c2. Therefore, y2 is equal to t squared times u of t, written here. So y2, the second solution, will be c1 times t squared ln t times c2 times t squared, okay, c2 times t squared. And we know the first solution, y1 of t, is equal to t squared, namely we have already the term t squared for the special solution, and we want to find the linearly independent second solution, namely the special solutions should be linearly independent, which means we don't need to write the second term since it is the multiple of the first special solution y1, which is t squared, and we have a multiple of this solution c2 times t squared. Therefore, when we write the second solution to get a linearly independent combination, so we don't need to write this term, so just we have c1 times t squared times ln t, and actually we take the second special solution for the earlier equation as t squared times ln t, okay. L and T. When we have repeated root for the characteristic equation of the Euler equation, okay? And when we check the Wronskian, you know the first row is the functions, the second row is the derivative of the first row, 2 times t, and using the product rule we obtain this one, and the determinant will be t cube, which is equal not equal to 0, for t is not equal to 0, which means they form a fundamental set of solutions, which means the general solution will be the linear combination of them, c1 times t square plus c2 times t square times ln t. Okay, the first solution is obtained by finding the value of r, which is the root of the characteristic equation of the Euler equation, and the second solution is obtained by multiplying the first special solution by ln t. Okay, so the last possibility is that we can have a complex root for the characteristic equation of the Euler equation. Therefore, the formula will be obtained by solving an example. You see, we have the Euler equation given by t squared times the second derivative plus 3 times t times the first derivative plus 5 y is equal to 0 for positive values of t. The power function solution leads to the characteristic equation written here. A is equal to 1, B is equal to plus 3, C is equal to 5. And from here we obtain r squared plus 2r plus 5 is equal to 0, which means the roots will be equal to minus b, namely minus 2, plus minus square root of discriminant, namely b square minus 4 times a times c. B square is 4 minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is equal to 5 for the polynomial equation written here, over 2a, which is equal to 2. And from here we obtain minus 1 minus plus 2i, minus plus 2i. So we have solutions if we use the first idea in this section. So we obtain t to the power minus 1 plus 2i, which is the first complex root. Y2 of t is equal to t to the power minus 1 minus 2i. Okay. Namely, we will have complex functions actually, but we should have real valued functions to find a fundamental set of solutions for the given differential equation, because it is defined on the set of real numbers. Therefore, the solution functions also should be defined on the set of real numbers. So to find the real valued functions for the special solutions, we use Euler's identity, which is given by exponential I times theta is equal to cosine theta plus I times sine theta. Okay, namely exponential I theta is equal to cosine theta plus I times sine theta. And the solutions for the example y1 is equal to t to the power minus 1 plus 2i minus 1 plus 2i, and the second solution is equal to t to the power minus 1 minus 2i. Okay, yes. So to use this identity, so we write the special solution y1 as t to the power minus 1 times t to the power 2i, and from here we write t to the power minus 1 times e to the power ln t to the power 2i, okay, to use this identity. The second term is written in this form. And from here we have, according to the property of the logarithm, you know, the second term can be written as t to the power minus 1 exponential 2i ln t, 2i ln t, and from here we have 1 over t times exponential 2 ln t, 2 ln t I. Okay, instead of theta we have 2 times ln t. Therefore it becomes, from the Euler's identity, instead of theta we write 2 times ln t. So cosine 2 times ln t plus I times sine 2 times ln t. And we have at the beginning 1 over t, of course. 1 over t. Okay. So from here, after finding this, so we see that. And similarly, we can find another version for y2 by using the Euler's identity. Another statement similarly. The second one similarly will be, namely y2. This is equal to y1 of t, and y2 of t will be 1 over t times. So cosine is an even function. Therefore, instead of minus 2, actually we have cosine minus 2 ln t plus I times sine minus 2 ln t, because the difference between them is just plus 2 and minus 2 here, you see. Therefore, instead of plus 2, we write minus 2, you see, minus 2. And from here, we have, for the second special solution, 1 over t is equal to cosine 2 ln t, since cosine is an even function and sine is an odd function. Therefore, the minus is written outside. 2 I times sine 2 ln t. And to get rid of I, so we write the special solution y1 tilde can be the addition of them over 2, y1 plus y2 over 2, such that the term with I will be removed. Okay, so we have 1 over t, 2 times cosine 2 ln t over 2, so this is equal to 1 over t times cosine 2 ln t. Okay, similarly, the second special solution will be the imaginary part, actually, or y1 minus y2 over 2, which is equal to t to the power minus 1 times sine 2 ln t. By similar consideration, we get the second special solution, which is a real valued function, y1 minus y2 over 2. Therefore, we obtain 1 over t sine 2 ln t. Sine 2 ln t. So from here we can check that the Wronskian of the new solutions will be equal to 2 times 1 over t cube, which is not equal to 0 for the positive values. Therefore, the general solution will be the linear combination of these special solutions, c1 times t to the power minus 1 times cosine 2 ln t, and c2 times t to the power minus 1 times sine 2 ln t, which means actually minus 1 is obtained from the real part of the complex number, which is the root of the characteristic equation, you see. And the number 2 is obtained by finding the imaginary part of the complex number, which is the root of the characteristic equation. Okay, therefore we can generate a formula in this case for the solution of the Euler equation. Okay, therefore by summarizing we obtain formulas for every case. To solve the Euler equation written here, a times 2 squared times the second derivative plus b times t the first derivative plus c times y is equal to 0, and we look for the power function solution, and it leads to the characteristic equation. And according to the roots, the first possibility is that if you have distinct real roots, the special solutions will be in this form and the general solution will be a linear combination of them. Okay, if you have repeated roots, namely R1 and R2 are equal to each other, the special solutions will be like this, like the example, which is the second example, t to the power r, t to the power r times ln t, and the linear, the general solution of the differential equation will be the linear combination of them, you see. And lastly, if you have complex roots, like this one, minus 1 minus plus 2i, you see, alpha is minus 1, beta is 2, so the special solutions will be t to the power alpha times cosine beta ln t and sine beta ln t, and the general solution will be the linear combination of them. Okay, this is the table for the solution formula of the differential equation called Euler equation, whose general form is written here. Okay, and to use the table we need to find the root of the characteristic equation written here. Okay, thank you very much.